Good day, everyone. I'm Kayla Chanle Andaya from PSTM 1101, and I'm here to discuss on how to eliminate the hazard and risk on hospitality industry. We all know that the hazard and risk will bring us to accident if we are not careful. So that's why I'm here to give you some ideas or knowledge on how to eliminate those things. Let's proceed. As you can see, this is my infographics. The content is what always happens in the hospitality industry when it comes to hazard and risk, and how we can eliminate, and what are the things that we need to do to avoid those things. But before that, let's identify what hazard and risk is. Hazard refers to a source of potential harm and danger. And the risk is, it refers to the possibility that harm and injury might occur when exposed to a hazard. Let's move on to the most common hazards in the hospitality industry. First is slips, trips, and falls. Businesses in the hospitality sector have many operational challenges, especially when they are at capacity. You will not surprise that slips, trips, and falls are among the most common causes of injury in this industry, particularly among chefs and waiting staff. Food spillages, wet floors, and trip hazards all contribute to this. Black walkways and waiting staff rushing to serve tables can all act as hazards. The second is injury from incorrect manual handling. In the hospitality environment, it is highly likely that staff will need to handle heavy items at time, such as tables, deliveries, luggage, full pads, and files of plates. This can lead to musculoskeletal injuries if they are handled incorrectly. Third is mental ill health. Those who work in hospitality are used to long hours in fast-paced environment. The role can often be pressured and stressful, which can contribute to mental ill health. Fourth is fire. Kitchen pose a greater risk of fire due to the use of gas, knife flames, and other flammable substances, ensuring staff understand how fire spreads, how to tackle it, and understanding emergency procedures will help to keep them safe in the event of a fire. Last is hazard chemicals. It can be found in cleaning agents, but they also include less obvious substances such as carbon dioxide gas. Commercial kitchens use many cleaning agents, and it is commonplace in hospitality for gas to be used for dispensing drinks. How we can eliminate the risk and hazard in the hospitality industry. Never take shortcuts. Labor Power conducts regular assessments and discussion with safe operators to ensure safety systems are up to date. Some of the safety systems put in place such as guarding on machinery and signage to protect the machine operator and other employees in the work area from hazards created during the machine's normal operation. Next is inductions and training to integrate new employees into the company and make them understand the systems and procedures followed by the organization. It will help employees to settle down quickly in the new work environment. Last is safety policies, procedures, and methods to reduce the risk to health and safety in the workplace and reduce the likelihood of an injury by ensuring that employees know how to work safely when carrying out the tasks involved in their job. The another things on how we can eliminate the risk and hazard in the hospitality industry is the hierarchy of hazard controls. So, what is hierarchy of hazard controls? This is the system used in industry to minimize or eliminate exposure to hazard. The hazard controls in the hierarchy are in order of decreasing effectiveness, such as elimination, substitution, engineering controls, administrative, and personal protective equipment. The elimination, including the substitution, is to remove the hazard from the workplace or substitute hazardous materials on machine with less hazardous ones. The third most effective means of controlling hazard is engineering controls. These do not eliminate hazards, but rather isolate people from hazards. Administrative controls are changes to the way people work. The examples of administrative controls include procedure changes, employees training, and installation of signs and warning labels. Administrative controls do not remove hazards, but limit and prevent people's exposure to the hazards, such as completing restaurant cleaning at night when fewer people are eating. Last is personal protective equipment. it is the least effective means of controlling hazards because of the high potential or damage to render PPE ineffective. Example, a chef's uniform or the tall blanche, white double-wristed jacket, pants in a black and white hand-stood pattern, apron, and also clogs for them to prevent injury by protecting from burns, cuts, and more. Here are the 6 steps in a hazard and risk control program. Step 1. Identify the hazard. It is a part of the process to evaluate if any particular situation, item, thing, etc. may have the potential to cause harm. Step 2 is to identify the risk, the process of determining risk that could potentially prevent hazard from achieving its objectives. Step 3 is to assess the risk to identifying and analyzing potential accidents that may negatively impact to the individuals or the environment. Step 4 is control the risk. It will implement proactive changes to reduce risk in the area. Step 5 is document the process. It is securing documentation cares more about the how of implementation than the what of process impact. Step 6 is monitor and review. It will help you to learn from what you have planned and what has been done. It helps with considering what changes need to be made in eliminating the risk and hazard in the hospitality industry. Some hazards and their controls will be specifically outlined in legislation. You, as an employer in the hospitality industry, you need to be responsible for taking all reasonable precautions to prevent injuries or accidents in the workplace. All employers should have the common goal of protecting the health and well-being of their employees, because the healthy and careful employees result in a positive workplace culture, higher productivity, and a foundation for minimal turnover. So, let's stay alert, don't get hurt. It's all for my presentation. Thanks for taking out of your busy schedule to watch my video.